Good morning, children. Today we will start with a new chapter, HCL. This chapter is divided into two parts. In the first video, we will discuss about hydrogen chloride gas, and in the second video, we will discuss about the hydrochloric acid. So in this lecture, lecture one, we will talk about the occurrence, laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas, its physical and chemical properties. The molecular formula of hydrogen chloride is HCl. Its molecular mass is 36.5. Now, in hydrogen chloride, you all know that it is a covalent bond present, but this is a polarized one due to the electronegativity difference between hydrogen and chlorine. This is the electron dot structure of HCl, and this is the orbital diagram, and this is forming a covalent bonding is present in between HCl. Occurrence of hydrogen chloride gas. Hydrogen chloride gas occurs in free state in volcanic emissions. Hydrogen chloride gas is water soluble. When dissolved in water, it produces hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid may be prepared from chloride salts. Glover prepared HCl from NaCl by heating it with sulfuric acid. Hydrochloric acid is present in gastric juices of mammals, but in a very low quantity, that is 0.2 to 0.4%, which is necessary for digestion. General preparation of HCl gas. It is formed by the direct combination of hydrogen and chlorine gas, that is the synthesis of H2 and Cl2. Moist hydrogen gas combines with chlorine gas in the presence of diffused sunlight. This is very important. H2 gas plus Cl2 gas in diffuse sunlight, it is produced 2HCl gas. The reaction is explosive in direct sunlight, but it is negligible in dark. However, in the presence of a catalyst such as activated carbon, it takes place even in the dark. Burning jet of hydrogen also burns in chlorine, forming hydrogen chloride. So for the preparation of hydrogen chloride gas from hydrogen gas and the chlorine gas, diffuse sunlight is required. If you are doing the experiment in the direct sunlight, then it will be explosive. The reaction is explosive. And in the negligible, it is negligible in dark. But in dark, this reaction can occur if you can perform the reaction in presence of a catalyst such as activated carbon. Heating metallic chloride with concentrated sulfuric acid also produced HCl gas. NaCl plus H2SO4 below 200 degrees centigrade. This is very important reaction. NaCl plus H2SO4 below 200 degrees centigrade, it is forming HCl gas. Along with that, it is forming NaHSO4, sodium bisulfate. And if the same reaction is carried over above 200 degrees centigrade. Then with HCl, we are getting Na2SO4. CuCl2, copper chloride with H2SO4, when heated, it is giving you HCl and CuSO4. Laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. The reactants are sodium chloride and concentrated sulfuric acid. What is the reaction? NaCl plus concentrated sulfuric acid below 200 degrees centigrade. This is very important, children. Below 200 degrees centigrade, it is forming HCl and NaHSO4. Though it is a reversible reaction, but it goes on to completion. Why? Because the hydrogen chloride gas continuously escapes. Okay, the reaction can occur up to a stage of the formation of sodium sulfate on heating above 200 degrees centigrade. If you heat it above 200 degrees centigrade, it will give you sodium sulfate. Laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. This is the experimental setup for the laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. This is divided into four parts, four steps. Step one, take common salt in a flask and pour concentrated sulfuric acid to it through a thistle funnel. Take sodium chloride in this round bottom flask and from this thistle funnel add concentrated H2SO4. Now in step 2, the flask is gently heated for controlled evolution of the gas, generally below 200 degrees centigrade. Now the gas will come out from here and it will go through this delivery tube. After that, in step 3, the gas is dried by passing it through a double mouthed container containing sulfuric acid. The sulfuric acid is taken in this container and through it the HCl is passed and it is getting dried over sulfuric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid. And then step 4, the gas is collected by upward displacement of air in a gas jar. Now from here the gas is coming out after the drying process and all, and then it is collected in this gas jar by the upward displacement of air. Heating above 200 degrees centigrade, the reaction occurs up to a stage of formation of sodium sulfate. But generally in the laboratory preparation of HCl gas, we are not increasing the pressure above 200 degrees centigrade. Why? That I am coming to next slide. Now NaHSO4 plus NaCl, because below 200 degrees centigrade, if I'll see, then what is the reaction I'm getting? I'm getting NaCl plus concentrated H2SO4 below 200 degrees centigrade. I'm getting NaHSO4 plus HCl. NaHSO4 plus HCl. Now this NaHSO4 plus again NaCl, it is giving you Na2SO4 plus HCl. Now NaCl plus H2SO4, I am getting Na2SO4 plus HCl is a total reaction. Some of the important notes in the laboratory preparation, during the laboratory preparation of HCl, we have to keep all these things in our mind. Sodium chloride is cheap and therefore it is preferred for the preparation of HCl over the other metal chlorides? This is a very important question. Why sodium chloride is used in the preparation of HCl gas? And the second one is, concentrated nitric acid is not used. Only concentrated sulfuric acid we are using. Concentrated nitric acid is not used during the preparation of HCl. Why? Very important question. Because it is volatile and may volatilize out along with hydrogen chloride. Okay, children. The purification of HCl gas, it is dried by passing through concentrated sulfuric acid. Other drying agents such as phosphorus pentoxide P2O5 or calcium dioxide CaO cannot be used. Why? As they react with HCl. These two reactions are very important. What is the reactions of HCl with P2O5? It is forming POCl3 plus HPO3, and with CaO it is forming CaCl2 plus H2O. So this P2O5 and CaO cannot be used for the drying purpose of HCl gas. That is why we are using concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay, now collection of HCl gas. HCl gas is being 1.28 times heavier than air is collected by upward displacement of air. And why it is not collected by the downward displacement of air? Because it is heavier. It is heavier than air. So it is not collected by the downward displacement of air. It is collected by the upward displacement of air. And HCl being highly water soluble, it is not collected over water. Am I clear? Identification of HCl gas. When the jar is completely filled with hydrogen chloride gas, white fumes appear above the mouth of the jar. This is because when hydrogen chloride comes in contact with the moisture of air, it instantly produces HCl vapor that gives rise to white fumes. If a rod dipped in an H4OH, this is the identification of HCl gas, which is very important. If a rod dipped in an H4OH is held near the mouth of HCl jar, dense white fumes will be produced if the jar is full of hydrogen chloride gas. Children, this is important. What are the precautions that we are taking? The lower end of the thistle funnel must be dipped in concentrated sulfuric acid. Delivery tube should be dipped in drying agent, that is concentrated sulfuric acid. The temperature, this is very important once again, the temperature should be maintained at about 200 degrees centigrade. Why? If the temperature is more than 200 degrees centigrade, then what will happen? The glass apparatus may break, fuel is wasted, and most importantly, sodium sulfate forms a hard crust over glass surface, which is difficult to remove. Children, this point is very important. Why? The temperature to be maintained at below 200 degrees centigrade. It should not be above 200 degrees centigrade. What are the 3 points? This is a very important question. Properties of hydrogen chloride gas. It is a colorless gas, pungent choking smell, it is having sour-like taste, It is an acidic one, so naturally it will have a sour-like taste. Then it is corrosive in nature. It irritates nose, throat, and lungs. It is about 1.25 times heavier than air. The vapor density of HCl is 18.25 and that of air is 14.4. Boiling point is minus 83 degrees centigrade. Melting point is minus 113 degrees centigrade. When subjected to a high pressure, nearly 40 atmosphere, at low temperature, nearly 10 degrees centigrade, it is liquefied to a colorless liquid. Hydrogen chloride gas is highly soluble in water. One volume of water dissolves in 452 volumes of the gas at room temperature. Just think, it's highly soluble. HCl, being polar covalent compound, is soluble in organic non-polar solvent also, such as acetone and toluene. An experiment to demonstrate that HCl gas is heavier than air. If a gas jar filled with HCl gas is poured into another jar which is containing a lighted candle, that is shown in this figure. To see here, this is the jar containing HCl gas. That HCl gas is poured into another jar where there is a lighted candle. After some times, what will happen? You can see that the lighted candle is extinguished. It gets extinguished. Why this is happening? Because as HCl gas is heavier than air, it will replace the air from this jar, and slowly makes the candle get extinguished. This also shows that HCl gas is neither combustible nor support combustion. Here is an experiment, very important experiment, to demonstrate that HCl gas is highly soluble in water. This is known as fountain experiment. High solubility of HCl in water may be demonstrated with the help of fountain experiment. Now, please see this figure, adjacent figure. A round bottom flask is filled with dry HCl gas. This one. This is the round bottom flask. This is filled with dry HCl gas. A rubber stopper with two holes is placed on the mouth of the round bottom flask. See, this is the rubber stopper with two holes. Through one hole, a long jet tube is passed. This is the long jet tube. And through another hole, a dropper with few drops of water is passed. This one, this is a small one. You can see here, this is the small one, dropper. Okay, from this dropper, water can pass. Okay, few drops of water. The jet tube is immersed in the beaker containing litmus solution, blue litmus solution. This jet tube, the lower end of the jet tube is immersed in a solution, in a beaker containing blue litmus solution. Okay, now when the dropper is pressed, what will happen? It is drops of water will enter into the round bottom flask. And what you can see, that the blue litmus water enters the flask through the jet tube with force, forming a red fountain. From here you can see that red fountain is formed. Okay, it is written here, red fountain. Why it is happening? What is the reason behind it? As the dropper is pressed, what will happen? Water drops instantly dissolve some HCl which is present in the round bottom flask. Okay, and it is creating a low pressure inside the round bottom flask. The outside pressure being more, blue litmus water enters the flask through that jet tube and reacts with the acid which is present inside the round bottom flask. Okay, and it turns red. Blue litmus, it is entering through the jet, and as HCl is present inside the round bottom flask, it is forming the red color which is coming out as a fountain because it is going inside through a pressure. This further causes a drop in the flask pressure. Okay, and more litmus water enters the flask and causing the fountain. This is known as fountain experiment. Okay, so what is the inference that you can draw from this experiment? The inference that you can draw from this experiment that HCl gas is highly soluble in water, which is present inside the round bottom flask, as we have pressed the dropper, the water enters, the drop of water enters through the dropper, and HCl gas which is present inside the round bottom flask get dissolved, and because of that the low pressure created, and to fulfill that the outside pressure is more, so the blue litmus solution will enter through the jet and forming red fountain as it is reacting with HCl gas. Okay, because of this reaction, further the pressure is dropping, so more litmus solution enters into the flask and it is causing a fountain. I think it is clear to you. Chemical properties of HCl gas. Combustibility. The gas is neither combustible nor a supporter of combustion. Thermal dissociation can happen. Thermal dissociation means on heating above 500 degrees centigrade, it can dissociate into hydrogen and chlorine. 2HCl above 500 degrees centigrade if you heat, then it is dissociate into H2 plus Cl2. Reaction with ammonia. It combines with ammonia to form dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. NH3 gas plus HCl gas is giving you NH4Cl. Fumes of NH4Cl, so you can say this is also a gas, you can say. So this is a reaction when two gases react together and the third gas is producing. Write a reaction of that. Okay. Reaction with metals. Metals that come before hydrogen in the electrochemical series, they react with HCl to produce hydrogen gas. But the metals which is coming below hydrogen in the electrochemical series, they will not react with HCl. Okay, now see here, sodium, calcium, magnesium, zinc, iron, they all are present above hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So when they are reacting with HCl, they are producing the chloride of that particular metal, so metal chloride, and hydrogen gas is liberating. NaCl plus H2. Ca plus 2HCl, it is giving you CaCl2 plus H2. Similarly, Fe plus 2HCl, it is giving you FeCl2 plus H2. Okay, so when metal react with HCl, it is giving its metallic chloride and hydrogen gas will be liberated. With this, we are coming to the end of lecture 1. In the next lecture on HCl, We shall describe laboratory preparation of hydrochloric acid, its physical and chemical properties, tests for chlorides and hydrochloric acid, and its uses including industrial and medicinal purpose. Go through the video properly, try to understand, and consult your book for better understanding. Children, if you have not subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel for a quick update or newly posted videos. Thank you.